The issue is with the Gree outdoor unit, specifically the motor, which isn't working. This is causing problems because if the motor doesn't function, the outdoor unit obviously won't work properly. As you can see, it's a UVW motor and its circuit is housed inside this PCB. Here you can also see the IPM, intelligent power module, mounted on it, with a heatsink attached. Now typically, when we supply power to it, we test it by checking the UVW points. This helps us determine whether it's faulty or not. I have already supplied power to it, and the switching has occurred, as indicated by the lights turning on. We'll take a ground from the last pin of the IPM, and then check the voltage at any point. At this point, we're getting a maximum of 14 volts. Similarly, when we check the next point, we also see a maximum of 14 volts there. Moving to the next point after that, the voltage is roughly the same, around 14 volts as well. This means that under normal circumstances, everything seems fine at this point, and there doesn't appear to be any issue. However, the outdoor fan motor still isn't working, which indicates there is a problem somewhere preventing it from not functioning properly. Now, we'll check it using another method. First, I'll turn off the power to the unit. After turning off the power, I'll discharge the capacitors. To discharge the capacitors, we'll do this. Both capacitors will be discharged, and now they have been properly discharged. Next, I'll change the mode of the multimeter, switching it to diode mode, or rather, let's leave it in continuity mode. We'll test in continuity mode, and as you can see, our meter is working perfectly. First, we need to check the bootstrapping capacitors. These capacitors are located here. Let me check them one by one. I'm testing it now, and there's no sound at all. I'll now change the polarity. After changing the polarity, we'll test again, and still there's no sound. Now I'll check the next capacitor. Again, I'll change its polarity and check it again. This one is also fine. Similarly, the third bootstrapping capacitor is located here. You can see its position near ZD2, and the capacitor number is C0704. Now when I check this capacitor, it gives us a continuous sound. I'll change the polarity again and test it. This time, it also gives a continuous sound. In this situation, if the capacitors are showing this behavior, it suggests that one of them might be short-circuited. However, it's also possible that they are functioning correctly. To verify, we need to recheck the components' positions. Now, I'll switch the multimeter to diode mode to check the Zener diode. Let's start with ZD3. In diode mode, it shows a maximum voltage drop of 0.6 volts. Similarly, the other Zener diode shows a voltage drop of 0.618 volts. Now I'll remove the heatsink to get a clearer view for the camera. After removing the heatsink, I'll check the Zener diode again. The cathode is on one side and the anode is on the other. Testing it now, the meter shows 0 volts. I'll change the polarity, placing the positive probe on the cathode and the negative probe on the anode, and it still shows 0 volts. Now, there is a chance that the IPM, intelligent power module, might be short-circuited from the inside for any reason. It's possible that either the capacitor or the diode is short-circuited, causing the problem. Additionally, there's a small capacitor here, which we should also check. I'll switch the multimeter back to continuity mode and test it. The meter shows a short circuit at this point as well. This suggests that there is likely a short circuit somewhere, either the capacitor, the diode. There is a higher chance that the diode is faulty. Therefore, the first step is to replace the diode. I will remove the diode from the system. After removing it, I will set the multimeter to continuity mode again and check it. We will place probes on capacitor, and still there is a sound in a system, and it's still not fixed. We need to remove both capacitors. I would like you to comment on whether you think the IPM is faulty or if the problem lies with the capacitor or diode. Before continuing with the video, make a guess. After removing the capacitor and checking the system again, I'll test the multimeter. Once we recheck, if the capacitors are no longer showing any sound or issues, it suggests an improvement. Next, I'll switch the multimeter to diode mode and test the points again. We should see some voltage drop, and a reading of 0.601 volts indicates that the IPM might be in good condition. Now I will show you the faulty component. First, let's test the diode to see if it's really shorted or not. We'll test the diode in diode mode, checking it from both sides. On one side, you can see there's no issue. Now we'll reverse the polarity and check again. Here, you can see a voltage drop of 0.669, which means the diode is perfectly fine and there's no fault with it. Next, I'll check the capacitor. For this, I'll switch the multimeter to continuity mode. As you can hear, there's a continuous beeping sound. Even if you leave it connected for hours, the beeping sound won't stop. Even though the capacitor should block DC voltage as soon as I change its polarity, but it's not doing so. Since the capacitor is not blocking DC voltage, It means the capacitor is shorted. We'll need to replace this capacitor. I'll now prepare the spot and install a new capacitor with a value of 10 microfarads. The capacitor has been installed, and now I will also install the diode. After that, I'll turn on the multimeter again and set it to continuity mode. I've tested the multimeter and it's working perfectly. As you can see, there's no sound now, even after changing the polarity, and no issues are detected. Next, I'll double-check the diode to confirm. By directly connecting the anode and cathode, we are getting a value of 0.608, which means the circuit is in the correct position and everything is functioning as expected. The fan should now work perfectly without any problems, indicating that the PCB has been successfully repaired. Now, I'll perform the final test. I'll set the multimeter to DC mode and check the DC voltages. The PCB is powered on, and I'll take the ground reading from here. The positive voltage readings should be around 14 volts, and we're getting a maximum of 14.92 volts, which is within the acceptable range. I'll check the next point, and it's the same. This confirms that the PCB is working perfectly, and there are no remaining issues. Finally, I'll test the motor as well, as it's important to ensure no further faults arise. I'll check its resistance value, and right now, it's showing a maximum value of 79.3 ohms. We'll check the resistance with the other terminals. The readings are 79.1 ohms for one and 79.3 ohms for another, indicating that the resistance values are correct and there are no issues with the motor's resistance. Next, I'll check for any shorts in the motor body. I'll place one probe on one point and the other probe on another point to see if there's any fluctuation or problem. If no issues are detected, it means the motor is in good condition. Since no problems are found, the motor is functioning correctly and there are no faults present.